Alright everyone, Devilman here, and I'm using Need for Speed Porsche Unleashed to make another video. This time it's actually about microevolution and macroevolution. A perfect example of this is actually the Porsche 911, which is why I'm using Need for Speed Porsche Unleashed, because it shows quite a lot of them. It's easier than going through and finding a whole bunch of pictures. Now, as you can see, I have quite a few of them on this exact save file. And it goes up to the 2000s, starting in 1965. Now, none will say that this guy, and let's see, where is he? This guy, are that much the same. They are distinctly different, but they got similar overall tendencies, but they are quite a bit different, I think we would all agree. But that's macroevolution. At the base ends, they're quite a bit different. The Corvette's another perfect example, one that I might use later in another video if I need to clarify a little bit better, but for now, let's start off with the Porsche 911. Now, this is a 65 911 coupe. I've used the coupes for all of these because it's easier, and you can see the overall shape on this one. Now let's fast forward to 2 years. See, only minor cosmetic differences. The rims are different, a little bit of badge right here, but otherwise, not too dissimilar, I think you would agree. 1972, again, quite the same. Rims are just a bit different, but all in all, minor changes at most. 73, you got this neat little fin on the Carrera version, but again, not too dissimilar. Let's see, 1975, you get this fin back here. The overall body shape is just minorly different. The bumper is a bit different, the nose, if I recall, is altered just a hair, but nothing really that significant. Not that far out. So we're on 75. Here's 78. Yeah, we're on 78. Again, looks like the ducktail here is modified just a smidge, but again, small change, but it is this version in 78 and the 65, there are noticeable differences between here and here. The body's a bit wider, the nose is a bit different overall. Just a smidge, but you can still see the remnants. Now, moving on, we have a huge jump here. They don't have any of them from the 1990s, which is annoying. We are 89! As you can see, decently different, but again, not too dissimilar. I wish they had more between here, but you gotta do with what you gotta do. And you can see, overall the same, but you can see the modifications. Again, the body's gotten a bit wider, the tail's ducked down, the nose is a bit different, but again, not too dissimilar. And here we are, 1990. 1 year later, nothing different, really. 91, again, for this one, it's the turbo, so it's a bit wider stance. It's got the fin on the back. But between this turbo, you can still see a decent amount of difference between here and here. 93, nothing really changed. 94, see the back end kind of slope down a bit. See the face is different between 93 and 94. Carrera. It's Carrera. See? Overall, decently different, but not too significant. It's just a minor point in the body style. Carrera 4, pretty much the same. 4S. Different rims. I think it had a little bit of widening on the wheel arches. Let's see, we're on the Boris, yeah. 1997, again, just a minor change. 98, it was elongated here, as you can see, between here and here. But again, nothing too radical between each version. And 99, and finally 2000. And it's where the evolution of the Porsche 911 at the date of this game's release was. There was a gradual change between each one. There was a bit difference, but not anything near as huge as this and this. Let's see, quite a significant gap. None would argue that these two are the same kind, so to speak. They are very distinct of one another. But you can see the gradually change of it. You can see trace elements of this in this, but they're very much different. So that's just, in short, a quick little look at microevolution and macroevolution. You have microevolution being the slight changes between each individual car. And macroevolution being this was between the 2000 911 Turbo and the 1965 911 Coupe. There you go. Alright, let's cover the Corvettes while I'm at it. And this is a very handy picture, which I do not own, by the way, but quite useful for this display. You can see it has almost every Corvette body style up to about 1998, which kind of same time frame as Porsche Unleashed, but it does the job. Now, you can see the individual differences between the 53 to 55 and the 56 to 57. Minor. Same thing with the 58 model is not that dissimilar. See, along the lines, that these are not that different from each other. Even the 62 and the 55, pretty close. And then if you come down to the 63, you notice it and the 55 are quite different, but the 63 and 62, pretty similar. I think you'll have to agree. This is the coupe version, this one's a convertible, but body-wise, they're not that different. And 64, again, the same. The 65, the 66 is a smidge different, but not too bad. And 67 and 68. Pretty much the same. Again, convertible versus coupe. I wish they would have just used coupes, but whatever. We have the 69 and the 70. Pretty close, but again, the 63 and 70, distinct from each other. And the 70 and the 53, quite a bit different. We have the 71, the 72, and the 73, 74, even the 75 and 70. Again, not too dissimilar, all things considered. Then it goes on and on to the 80s, where it starts morphing into, well, a different body style, but again, it's pretty gradual. Gradual, if you look between here and here, you can see quite a small, short chain between them. The 86 and the 87. Here we have that 12-year difference. See, not that dissimilar, but they are fairly distinct. I mean, you have the 80s and the 90s. And you can see a clear progression. But this and this are very distinct from each other, more so than the 911s. The Corvette's actually a better example than the 911 because it's more distinct. The 911 was just the easiest for what I had. But here you can see a very clear chain of evolution between here and here. These are very different, but each individual one is pretty close to each other. Now you're going to argue, well, this is cars. What does this have to do with animals and people? Well, people are animals, but evolution is just a basic concept. Things change over time, and this is a perfect example. Animals are just like cars in that they change over time. The time scale is quite a bit different. This is, let's see, 45 years, roughly. Yeah, had to double check my math there. But yeah, 45 years is what this did. But for people and other animals, you have to multiply that at least by 1,000. Because you need a lot more generations to get things going. Because change happens between generations. Two people, man and a woman, they have a child. That child is neither the man or the woman. It's a completely different entity that's distinct on its own right. Whoa, what the hell? Thank you, Windows 7, for being a butt. Anyways, the child is not the father or the mother. It's distinct on its own. It's different. Enough generational differences, you'll see a very distinct difference eventually down the line. Animals with shorter lifespans have been observed to have actual evolution. We've seen it. We've seen macroevolution in action with, I think it was fruit flies, something along those lines. Longer living animals like tortoises, you're not going to see any difference in your lifetime because you're not going to see a second generation. You're going to be lucky to live to 80. And they're living 120 and some on, or more. You're not going to see that much change between the two generations. But for us, it's going to take quite a ways. And you can see it for yourself, what these changes amount to. When you have interracial couples, you have a black guy, white woman, the son, our daughter, not in between that. So that's just the basic principle of evolution, how it works, and a really good example on outside of the animal kingdom that you can look at and say, hey, that makes sense. I know people are still going to deny it, but for those of us that use reason and rationality, you can point to this, and maybe you might get a few people to understand the concept a little bit better. Hopefully, all this helped for you, and you have a jolly good day.